West, Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider. No, you don't want nada. None of this. Six gunning this, brother running this. Buffalo soldier. Look, it's like I told you. Any damsel that's in distress, be out of that dress when she meet Jim West. Rough neck, so go check the lawn to buy. Watch your step, reflex, and get a hold of your size.
What up? What's going on?
Fucking dude, chilling.
Just fucking?
Just fucking chilling.
Just straight up. Fucking.
Fucking hard, dude.
Fuck yeah.
Fucking fast. Yes, dude. Oh my god. Wow. Out of the bowels.
Welcome
comes
to the
episode 28.
Thunderdome, dude.
Holy shit, that was a long fart.
That was a long fart.
That was fucking nice. Yeah. Really happy, but that's a good way to kick it off.
I wish I had a cooler catchphrase after the fart. Then dude, welcome to the Thunderdome. Should have said something cooler.
No, Thunderdome's sick.
It's like in your fucking face.
ISIS.
Yeah.
That was a fart directly to, if we have any ISIS listeners, that was a fart, was directly towards you.
That was the mother of all farts.
That was the Moaf, dude. Right to you guys, you fucking cowards.
Dude, hitting fucking Ariana Grande's concert.
Jesus Christ, man.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about that one.
Dude, I mean, the only thing is like,
Jesus.
Who the fuck's drumming up these plans?
Yeah, I know.
We will go to the Ariana Grande.
For me, like, we must destroy the Ariana Grande concerts.
Oh, which one is that? Is that I walked out the plane at LAX? Like, no, that's the other one. We'll get her next. That's the Miley Cyrus.
She's, we must, for me, I sing of Ariana Grande in my gardens all day. We must destroy her for making me get hard.
She gives me uncomfortable erection.
We must cut off the hands of her followers because I have a semi-boner.
Every morning I kiss the ground and listen to Aladdin music. And I think of her butt and I must destroy it. And all of her hot little fans.
Oh, man.
What a bunch of fucking assholes.
Dude, you know how fucking douchey you have to be to put on a fucking suicide vest and run into a group of fucking teen girls in England?
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck?
I think there's a lot of inbreeding that goes on over there. I think we're fighting, like, pure fucking gremlins.
Fucking retards?
These are pure gremlins, dude.
They are, dude. This
just
is,
like,
this is trouble.
That's not trouble. If you bomb an area.
No, I'm not saying us. I'm saying them.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
That's trouble. I'm not saying you and me. I'm
oh,
not
yeah,
worried.
So fuck that, dude. I'm
gloves are off right now
yeah,
with those
exactly.
boys.
Fuck that, dude.
That's
insane.
Yeah, especially
who the fuck doled that out.
I will. This might come off as insensitive, but this is one thing I also took from that because there's a lot of footage of it.
Yeah.
Is there anything worse than when shit like that happens? Just women just scream.
Yeah.
And they just happen to hit the one building that would definitely have the most screams.
Well, the weird part,
like,
when
there was an explosion, and that whole arena was little girls screaming.
Yeah.
Like, that was fucking crazy to watch that footage.
It was insane, but it was also, I watched it, my first thought, I was like, holy shit, this is the same scream as if Ariana Grande came out. It was the same exact scream, though.
Fuck,
literally, what? It was.
Dude,
it was. It was the same fucking fan. I was like, holy shit, this sounds like a fucking concert. That was crazy. That's just a weird note.
That is a weird note. I mean, and the thing,
that was
you're not trying to be funny.
I'm
it's
not. That was
totally
like, honest,
true.
It was this morning, I woke up, like, that sounds exactly like if she came out. I've been
if
to
she
concert
was on
before.
Stage, yeah.
It was just like, ah. And I was just yeah. like, holy fuck, that's weird. I felt the same thing before, though, when, like, girls I know stub their toe. Girls stub their toe, it sounds like they're coming. They're like, ah, and I'm like, oh, fuck yeah, dude. I've, like, dated a girl before who, like, hit their toe real
hard.
Are you
trying to get off that topic?
No,
that,
I'm just saying.
That fucking Moab you just dropped, dude. That was, like, a fucking.
That's not a joke. That's literally, I was like, wow, that sounds just like fanfare. It's weird. That must, there's, my whole
yeah,
thing
yeah,
was
yeah.
like, that must have been confusing because there's probably people who heard that yell who were like, oh, cool, what's going on? And
yeah.
they're just like, oh, no.
No, I think what was creepy about it was there's definitely this loud explosion, and then there was a lot of people, like, the scream permeated from the around the explosion.
Yeah.
And then the people in the arena were like, what the fuck was that? And then they just, you know, uncontrollably screamed.
Yeah.
It was like this chain reaction of screaming from it.
Hey, dude, it must have been
yeah.
chaos. Dude. There's no, I mean.
A bunch of little girls, and think if you were, like, a fucking parent, and you were chaperoning and taking, like, five kids.
Dude, I'd be.
And now you gotta fucking wrangle them.
I mean, I would just join the army the next day. I'd be like, all right, well, fuck this. I'm joining the army. I would just become a drone pilot.
I told you that was the one time I was like fucking hyped to be going to the army, right? When I saw Flight 93 in theater.
Oh, you're hyped to go.
Flight 93. I sat there and watched it, and it was like right after I committed to West Point.
Were you in your fatigues?
No, of course not. But I was wearing a hat. I was wearing like a West Point hat.
You had your
like
covers.
A football team hat.
Oh, nice. You're the base.
No, like the Army, gotcha. Army football hat.
Yeah.
And like I watched that movie, and I walked out like, I'm going to get these guys.
Those,
those
movies get me every
time. Yeah, propaganda will get you.
I fall for it instantly.
I think my dad said when he saw like Tora, Tora, Tora as a kid, he like tried to punch a Japanese kid. He was like, I left that theater. I was so pissed.
It'll get you, dude. My peasant brain just instantly is like, God, fucking propaganda. Damn it. I fall for it instantly. It'll
fucking get us.
I fall for it instantly.
But yeah, that was our hot take on the how fucking gay ISIS is.
Yeah, that's fucking insane.
They just, dude, it's like, I've seen a lot of memes coming out of Europe right now. The alt-right's picking up over there. Anytime something like this happens, they're like, everybody politicizes it, but they're like, you've seen those memes, right, of like how Europe handles tragedy?
No.
It's like step one. Like flowers and music at the where it happened.
Yeah.
Like step two, Facebook profile pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Three is like lights on buildings around Europe to the flag of the country affected. And then step four is like allow more immigrants into the country. Step five, repeat.
Jesus like, Christ.
And some of the boys are getting fired up over there.
Oh, dude, that's like. After 9/11 happened, my dad had this like the terrorist hunting permit on his fucking truck for a while.
Oh boy!
Yeah, he was rocking that thing hard.
That's sick.
Yeah, dude, it was pretty tight. I remember I was little and I was like, "Damn, I'm gonna get one of those in my car."
I have like a fucking T-shirt that says like "Bin Laden don't surf." I don't even get the reference. I think it's from Apocalypse Now.
Really?
Doesn't make any sense.
I don't get it.
To me, but
is that from when they threw him in the ocean?
I have like an aunt in Florida that bought it for me.
Oh, you have a T-shirt that says
It says Bin Laden don't surf.
Is this after?
Because in Apocalypse Now they say Charlie don't surf.
Oh, okay.
I guess Bin Laden is the new
Charlie. Damn, dude.
The time I'm not.
It's a
sure.
hard fucking T-shirt.
I don't think I wore it once.
You've been groomed from a young age, dude.
Yeah, man.
That's sick. You've been groomed for this podcast from a young age.
Fuck yeah.
It's fucking tight.
Yeah.
I've actually, I've come across a pretty tough thought recently.
I'm sorry to cut you off. That Ariana Grande take of yours is resonating in my head.
Why? That was the first thing in the morning. I'm like, dude, those screams sound like fanfare. I was like, that must have been confusing for people.
They did react the exact same way to the bomb as they would her.
They did. It's fucked up. It's horrible.
Yeah, it's really sad.
It's a sad thing, but it's like, dude, that's, you know, I had that. I was like, holy shit.
Yeah, that's one that, like, again, dude, these terrorist attacks on, like, you know, that's people always complain, like, why didn't, like, if there's a terrorist attack in Nigeria,
yeah,
it's like, why don't we have our profile pictures as that? Because I remember there was one in, like, I think Nigeria around the same time as Paris.
Yeah, I remember that.
And it's like, well, clearly we relate to the one in Paris.
Yeah.
Like, you can put yourself in that situation.
Yeah.
I can't imagine being in a school in Nigeria and a bunch of guys come in with machetes and start killing us.
Yeah.
Because I think that's what happened there.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, like, and it's disgusting. It's horrible. But, like, I can relate to Paris where you're, like, out to dinner with your girlfriend in a cafe, in a beautiful cafe.
And the line in the streets.
For me, I love the cigarette after the meals. The favorite is a duck for me. And then a man comes and he shoots. He's unhappy with us.
He does not like our ways.
Sparkling water glasses exploding everywhere. That's terrible. But like that's why, like, of course, like, I can see myself, not myself, but I know the people that were at the area, that concert.
Yeah.
I know who that was.
Yeah, it's
those
true.
Little fucking teenage girls.
Yeah.
Some miserable fucking dad or some mom that was like.
Some dude in white Champion sneakers.
In a fucking T-shirt that they made before that's like, Ariana, we love you. And it's just it's a fucking mindless, nice thing for a little girl to have fun. And then some fucking douche with a vest is like, God wills it. Blows like, himself up. It's like, dude, you're a faggot. Get out of here. You're fucking gay, dude. You're mad, dude. Get away.
Yeah, dude. To me, it's like, I mean, I will offer an olive branch. Any Muslims that want to join Christianity, dude.
No, Matt.
I'm just saying, dude. The writing's on the wall, dude. These things, these holy wars have been happening forever, dude. Winner takes all. It's like, join the fucking squad, baby. Come aboard.
No, because I don't like the other Christianities.
Eat some flavorless bread.
No, I just like Catholicism, dude. Just Catholicism.
That's the winning. You have to understand, like, dude, it's the winning team.
For sure.
It's the fucking 93 Bulls. It's hop on. Exactly. It's just hop aboard, dude. You can eat fucking whatever meat you want.
For sure.
It's just, come on. You don't have to fucking blow people up.
Yeah, all you have to do is be nice.
Exactly.
You get drunk. That's it.
Yeah, you drink wine at church. It's sick.
Yeah. Every once in a while, a kid gets diddled, but they're used to that.
Yeah.
They have that same problem.
What's that shit called? Boca Bachi Boys or something?
I know that all those, the Middle East is, they're down with a lot of touches. They're down with the little boys.
Yeah, dude. Chain them up. You find the prettiest boy in the village.
For me. The most hairless young boy.
This is just, these people are going to think we're doing a shitty Borat impersonation.
No, it's not. Anyway.
It has devolved into that.
Dude, I forgot. So this is what I started saying. I forgot, but I came across a thing today.
No, I cut you off.
What?
The first time. Yeah. No, and again, yeah, no.
There was I'm starting to wonder if I think black dudes are nerds now, man. I think they lost it. I'm like, because I the anime, dude, I saw the anime and I was like, all right, whatever. Now, do you see the finger spinners?
Yeah.
They just walk around. I'm like, all right, dude, fuck no. You guys lost me. I used to blindly be like, well, if you guys, this is
probably
cool.
Well, no, it's not that they're nerds. It's just, it's not cool to be the pop culture. And black people are pop culture.
No, I'm thinking more like the things they got into. Like anime, I was like, I'll give you that one. Then it was like hoverboards. I'm like, you guys look like fucking retards on these things. And then now it's the finger spinners. I'm like, all right, you guys clearly are fucking losing it. I think they're losing the mojo, dude. They're losing
their
awesome
power. I'll tell you what,
awesome,
I listened
powers
to a song. Yeah, I think, because I've been listening to this, a lot of the new rap, and it's all like emo.
Yeah.
It's all like, all my friends are dead. All my friends are dead. Like, that's a song. The one song's like,
Jesus.
By Logic, that's just like, I wish I was dead.
Really?
Yeah, dude. Black dudes, young black kids are fucking emo as fuck right now.
You know what's happening? There's a lot of Molly being eaten.
They're emo.
It's making them emo. I watched the documentary and they're like popping Molly's in the studio and they're like, I miss my cousin. And it's like, what the fuck, dude? This sucks.
Yeah, yeah.
Stop fucking spinning that shit, dude.
They're all singers. Yeah. They're getting emo, dude.
I think there's just a weird, like, as white dudes are losing power, it's just this weird, like, fucking homeostasis of, like, their cool points are slowly getting sucked in.
You think white dudes are losing power?
Yeah.
Why do you think that?
I mean, it's just like we just got knocked down a peg, and I think the like white power to fucking black coolness.
Why don't you chill with fucking
white
power.
I'm not saying white power. I'm saying like
you are saying white power.
That to black coolness.
Dude, this is not what I wanted from this cast.
It's not bad. Listen, it's just please hear me out. All right, I'm saying sorry. I'm not fucking obviously a white nationalist. I'm saying like the overarching thing, and they'll say too, like the systematic white power to black coolness is a ratio that has to maintain even at all times. So as white dudes slip, they start fucking
yeah, that's what I was
anime.
Saying. Like, they become more pop culture.
Yeah.
It's not underground and counterculture anymore, which is cool. Yeah. Counterculture is cool.
I'm thinking more nerdy, dude. I'm not even thinking
but now they're getting comfortable enough that they can, you know, you don't have to be hardcore all the time. You can talk about fucking Dragon Ball Z a little bit.
Dude, but nobody does. No, you can't.
You can
that's
be
nerdy. That's nerd stuff.
Of course it's nerdy, but we've always had nerds because white people have always been allowed to be themselves.
That's true.
Black people are finally becoming themselves, and now I don't know if they're going to like what they see.
What?
They're just inner nerd?
They're
just as corny as white people. All those fucking goofy fucking outfits they wear every day, pretty soon that's going to be like, what the fuck are you guys doing? Put on a t-shirt and jeans, dude. Fucking
hell
chill.
Yeah. Tuck it in.
Tuck in those fucking t-shirts.
Hike those fucking dungarees.
Hike those fucking dungarees up and study, dude. Clean up your room and study. No more palling around with your buddies and your blunts.
Dude, we gotta start taking the blunts off the street.
Fuck yeah.
That's a good fucking move.
Sitting around playing hip hop music all hours of the night.
Yeah.
It's time for you and your buddies to fucking study.
I don't know.
Those trousers.
I think that's happening, man.
Yeah, I think that's fair.
The hoverboards, the fucking Digimon, or might just be further into the future than us.
Black dudes?
Yeah, just like
I don't think
anime hoverboards, fucking finger spinners. I don't know what the fuck those things are.
No,
they might be on a different timeline, dude.
Dude, I was at the
they're in the future.
I was at the corner store.
Yeah,
and I saw like five black. It was packed. It was Saturday night.
Okay,
it was like a block party.
Yeah,
and then like old black ladies were buying like candy.
Okay,
it's just weird. Seeing like adults be like, yeah, could I get a bag of Cheetos and some Swedish fish?
Dude.
They were like 40.
I told you about my brief tryst with the lady who owned a convenience store.
No.
I never told you about that?
No, I don't think.
When I was, this was like 5 or 6 years ago, before, you know, before my first marriage, I was like dating this lady. I met her in the Restaurant Depot and, you know, we hit it off. Obviously I let her put her stuff on my like big Home Depot cart thing.
Oh boy.
So dude, this lady owned a convenience store. Yeah. So I had fleas in my house. So I had to stay in this.
Wait, what?
I got fleas in my house. I ended up getting a bad flea infestation. So I couldn't be in my house. This lady's like, she had gotten kicked out her ex-boyfriend.
You recognize you tried to just slide that into conversation, right?
Oh, I got fleas. It happens. All right,
sorry. Yeah.
It happens,
so she, dude. Something about your ex-boyfriend?
Check your privilege, dude. So her ex-boyfriend got deported for having an AK-47. So she was like, he owned this store, but now it's mine because he got kicked out of the country. So you can come. I'm sleeping in the store right now because I lost my house. So I slept in this convenience store with this lady for like 3 days. And every night before we went to bed, we'd have sex. And then she would like smoke a blunt, chomp Swedish fish, and just pass out.
I'd be like, what the fuck? They love sweets, dude. They love candy.
I would be laying there. I'm like, you don't want to brush your teeth? And she'd be like, no, I'm good. And I just be like,
I love sweets.
You're just going to crush fucking. She would like crush a warhead, dude, and fucking go to sleep. Remember, you would watch Madea and we would sleep on the floor of this convenience store.
You would watch Madea in a convenience store?
We'd lay behind bulletproof glass on the floor and fucking we watched Madea and I'd wake up to like the menu. You know, like a DVD menus we playing?
Yeah, that's the worst.
I'd just wake up to like an empty condom wrapper and just fucking like half of a drinking like Crystal Light bottle squeezer thing.
Oh, my God, man.
Just be like, what's up, baby?
Oh,
she's a
man.
Good girl. She was a great girl.
Seeing that like
she took me in, dude.
That like DVD player logo bouncing around the screen like a screensaver.
it was bouncing around the screen. It was like, boy, I'm gonna get you. Oh, boy, I'm, and gosh. I just wake up to it on like a pad. Like you would take a pad off a couch of like a futon type thing. We would just sleep on the floor, dude. I'd wake up behind this bulletproof glass, like, oh man.
Yeah, no, I will. This is a little off topic. I'm gonna get off the topic of black people eating candy.
Yeah.
And I do want to point out the fact that if any of these dumb cunts ever want to call us fucking, you know, alt-right, white nationalists, racist, fucking Matt just told a story where he laid with a black lady in a convenience store behind bulletproof glass and watched Madea at night. He slept in a fucking bodega for 3 days.
Yeah. That was my baby, dude.
Like a Puerto Rican's cat. Dude, that's fucking insane.
Dude, it was tight. We would like smoke a blunt, and then she would fucking eat Swedish fish, and we'd like make out, and then we'd go to sleep.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw a bunch of ladies getting candy, and I was just like,
"Yeah, dude,
that's a weird."
You just crush it.
So back to the hoverboards and fidgets. Oh, yeah. I don't think they're in the future. I think they're all like Tom Hanks and Big.
What's that?
Like where you just grow up, but you're still a little kid.
Oh my God!
So you get some money, you just start buying fucking random shit
that's
like
horrible.
Toys and candy.
Oh my God, dude. Now we were on a positive note, dude.
That's
backslid.
Funny, that's
hilarious.
That's a good take. Every older black person is just Tom Hanks and Big.
They like just fucking redeemed their tickets at an arcade. It's like finger spinners and hoverboards.
Stuffed animals and shit. That's why you see so many black ladies with stuffed animals on the back of their car.
So you're saying that they're just always fucking crushing like arcade and racking up. What game do you think they're playing and racking up all those tickets?
They're cheating in skee ball.
Really?
They're sitting up there just throwing the ball in. You know what I mean? They're dunking it in.
I heisted an arcade ticket thing one time.
Really?
It was open. I just fucking ripped a stack out. And the guy was like, these are like 4,000 tickets intact. And I was like, yeah, dude, I fucking hit the jackpot on Snake Canyon.
Snake Canyon. Oh, yeah. I do want to apologize to you publicly.
Why?
I was very harsh to you last episode about your infatuation with ladyboy porn.
Yeah, dude.
Turns out you've had an outpouring of support, a
real
outreach from the rest of our community.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Saying like, yeah, everybody does that.
Yeah. Everyone gets sucked into the LBs. You
get
sucked in, dude. It starts out, I'm not going to even delve into it, but it starts out.
No, we don't need to go into it again. But
you're watching with the girls and you're like, this is cool. More tits.
Yeah, no, it makes sense.
Put those
I get it.
Videos on the bottom. You're like,
let's see what's going on here.
That's hilarious. No, dude, I don't care.
But yeah, I want you to know some.
Thank you.
Good friends of the cast have come out
Thank
in your
you.
Support.
Hell yeah.
And
they'll get you.
Yeah, I was surprised how many people were like, yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, hell yeah.
It's kind of like it's kind of like standing up to wipe your ass. There's just another world I didn't know about. And everybody that does it thinks it's acceptable.
It's literally, I used to just fucking like do total front wiping.
Towards your sack.
Yeah. I used to just dab towards my sack and just bring it up like a fucking fine oil painting, dude. But I can't. My ass is too fucking big and voluptuous, dude. I can't turn and like lean over.
John, dude.
I have a fat fucking
ass.
That
actually might be why I get away with it, because I have such a flat ass.
You have a dog ass, dude.
I have a fucking Hank Hill ass. It's a fucking straight line, dude.
You just have like an ass like a fucking dog, dude.
And I have a tiny fucking butt crack, dude. It's real sad.
What?
Yeah, I have like a... it looks like it's just terrible.
It looks like Mike Judge drew
like
your butt.
Yeah, it's like an inverted butt. It's fucking crazy.
Oh, that's so fucking funny.
I'm fucking self-conscious about it.
Your butt?
Yeah.
Man.
Caitlin fucking spanked it the other day. I was like, get out of here. Not like sexually, but just like it was like I was walking by.
I mean, I didn't
like,
assume it was a sexual spank.
No, it's not like I was
I'm
getting
just imagining
spanked
you
in the
donning
bed.
Full leather, dude, with a fucking like metal thing in your mouth. Like.
Oh, yeah. That reminds me of fucking when you were talking about getting your butt eaten.
Yeah.
And I said, I guess doggy style would be my choice.
Oh, yeah.
Ari Spears did that bit.
About being embarrassed.
About he was like, I can't get my butt eaten because there's only two ways to get your butt eaten.
Yeah.
Legs up or doggy style.
It's true.
No, then you were like, I would just bend over.
Bend over,
lift
standing.
My leg like Captain Morgan.
True. There's a billion ways to do it.
The old pirate ass.
Fucking, if you can like, smother her, face riding, dude.
Like Rikishi. All right.
We'll take a break, see? We're at 20 minutes.
Yeah, sure.
Take a little break, sir. Whoppa. And we're back, dude.
Sick break. Oh,
thank
we
you.
Forgot shout outs last week.
True. Shout out Kev Nix. What's up, baby?
What up, boy? What up, Joey Gilson?
Wow.
What up, Dix?
Wow.
What up, Eric Glazer?
Yeah.
That's
dude.
A young bull from Baltimore, dude. He filmed he filmed that set I did down there.
Fuck yeah. What about Chad really nice. Cobles?
Chad
dude?
Just got fired up and just
Chadwick.
Posted.
Did he?
He just posted on a show, an event page for a show I'm doing in Harrisburg.
Hell yeah, dude.
He's talking about. He said, like, people of color and retards in one comment.
Chad's getting fired up.
Chad might have to delete that shit.
Shout out Chris Brown.
Yo, shout out Rocco.
Rocco, dude.
Rocco's the bull, dude.
Smooth Rocco.
Yep.
He's a suave fellow.
Yeah. Gerben. What up, boy?
Stevie Gerbs, dude.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, dude. Back, we're back with some heavy shout-outs.
Yeah, well, this is 2 weeks of shout-out. We're back. We're back.
I know.
You know, the boys, dude. You know, Christian's boys.
Christian
from
and the boys, dude.
Christian and the two backups.
Christian and the fucking heartbreakers.
Oh, fucking Nick and Patrick.
The Christian experience.
Those are the actual dogs.
Yeah, dude.
Those are good boys. Anyway, those are the shout outs. That's the shout outs for the week.
Yeah. What
else
is cracking, bro?
We're getting
bro?
Too many listeners, dude.
I know. You know?
We're getting too many.
I know. We got to scale it back a little bit.
We might have to scale out shout outs, dude.
It's just annoying how many people are listening right now.
So many people are fucking begging us for shout outs.
Well, fuck,
that's,
man.
You know, that's the price of fucking greatness.
Exactly.
You bring out a podcast like this.
Yeah.
At a time when people are clamoring for fucking truth.
Dude.
And sickness.
Directionless. Just a ton of lemmings.
Yep. And here come two dark nights.
Blinding light, dude.
This isn't what
it's
they...
It's the sun rising between the mountains.
It is.
You guys have been shivering, dude, in your half-truths, and all of a sudden the sun came up over the mountains and just glowed upon you.
And here you are.
Settling your goose prickled flesh. Hell yeah, dude.
Oh, I went back and listened to like our first couple episodes.
Yeah.
They're so fucking bad.
Yeah. What the fuck? I couldn't even.
It's,
I don't
just,
even,
it's
I
like
couldn't
an
even
NPR
you.
Voice, like, hey, Matt, how are you?
Hey, what's going on?
It's
man?
Good to be here on the podcast. I had a very smooth jazz radio announcer.
Dude, you do.
I had a fucking NPR, like, hey, Matt, how are you?
That's awesome.
It's good to be here.
And this next collection is going to be...
And I'll tell you what, I'm not a big fan of the Jews.
Damn.
No,
this is
I was,
a dry cast, dude.
I was thinking, yeah, this is dry. That's probably why... it started out hot.
No, it's
this
a good cast. I'm
takes.
Saying it's dry as in no alcohol.
No, I know that's what you meant. But normally, we've been getting pretty hot with the alcohol.
We do.
Without alcohol, we're scholars, man.
We are. We're fucking rogue scholars. If I get two drinks of me, it's just like...
You said rogue scholars, right?
Rogue.
Rogue scholars?
Yeah. Because that's not the fucking way. I thought it was rogue scholars, dude. I thought if I was like, damn,
I mean, technically that works. I understand why you thought it was that, because you could be a rogue scholar. You literally could be a rogue.
I am.
It's Rhodes.
It's a Rhodes scholar?
Rhodes scholar.
Like a road dog?
It's like R-H-O-D-E-S.
Oh, not like a road dog.
I could have spelled that wrong, which...
No, R-H-O-D-E-S.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's Rhodes Scholar.
Oh, the second attempt. I thought you meant like a road, like a traveling scholar, like a fucking his fucking like gown and cap and just wandered around.
No.
So Rhodes Scholar.
Yes.
All right. I'm a rogue fucking scholar, dude. I'm a fucking super rogue scholar.
You're rogue as fuck.
Hell yeah.
You're a fucking maverick.
Of course.
Rogue scholar. Well, here's what I want to say. It's going to be funny going back, like, the same way I listened to that first episode, we're going to go back and listen to this.
Yeah.
And this is basically like a letter to yourself. You can write yourself a letter in, like, 5 years.
True.
Right now. That's I remember we did that in eighth grade.
Did you really?
Yeah, we wrote a letter to ourselves.
Yeah.
And then I opened it my senior year of high school, and I forgot I wrote it.
Yeah, yeah.
But then the vision of myself I had was negative. I was like, I was probably a fucking dickhead in eighth grade.
Yeah.
Not funny. Or not reasonable.
Uh-huh.
So, like, I remember reading the letter, and it was like, you probably have offers from Florida State and Notre Dame right now, fucking killing it. But then the next paragraph was like, no, I'm kidding. But hopefully you at least went D2. You're the man. See ya. I was like, fuck yeah. Eighth grade me was the
crazy.
Shit.
That's so funny.
And I was wondering what you would say to yourself.
Me?
In 5 years from now. You and your definite transvestite wife.
Yeah, right, dude.
You're definitely going to have...
Bite your fucking tongue.
Transgender... lady.
My transgender wife?
Well, it's going to be a dude with a chick with a dick.
Dude,
by then
I,
it's going to be totally acceptable and you're going to be all in on that.
If I, it depends on how much money I get.
Okay.
If I were to get, if I was a multimillionaire, dude, definitely.
Well, you're talking to yourself in the future right now.
You're like, yo, dude, you're definitely going to have a hot tranny wife. Just keep at it, grind it out. Otherwise, you have to have a normal fucking chick, dude. That'd be gay.
Yeah. Or, you know what you could be doing right now?
What?
Like, I could be, right now, I could be in a car dealership listening to this on my headphones, just thinking about the good old days, man.
That would be so funny.
Thinking about how sick it was when I had this podcast and I did comedy.
Oh, definitely.
Now I'm sitting here in this desk. If I am talking to that version of me, get up right now and get the fuck out of there, dude.
Yeah.
Go back to comedy.
Hell yeah.
All right, good.
Sexually harass your coworker and get out of there.
Yeah, pat that hot chick on the ass that you've been talking to. Caitlin's dead by now. Oh, yeah. Caitlin's already dead. Don't worry, dude. It's 5 years from now.
Caitlin fell in a horrible hiking accident,
yes.
Dude.
Yes. She was out jogging.
And you fell depressed and you went and sold cars. Then you had to fucking smack the lady's ass and get out of there.
I don't know. I thought that might be funny. I don't know if it's funny at all. Oh, man. So you want to talk about fucking set life or do you feel like
that's... Yeah, we can talk about set life.
You seem to get very... off put when I bring that up.
No. I wasn't there, so I have nothing to say.
Well, you've been on Set Life.
Oh, I know all about Set Life, dude.
You love Set Life.
I fucking love it, dude.
These people have no idea what we talked about.
You hang out on an acting set. We had to go. The whole reason this, we basically slapping this podcast together because we have to go be on TV real quick.
Yeah, we got to go. Just a quick Comedy Central pilot that me and Matt are on.
Yeah, it's kind of a pain. It's kind of messing up our schedule, but we decided we'll go down there for the hell of it.
Kind of fucking up our podcast schedule.
Yeah,
but
it's kind of fucking annoying, really. But
the guys who are putting together that pilot are big fans of the cast and they just want to have us drop in, see what we can do to improve it.
I'm definitely going to wear all black.
See what we can do to improve their show.
I'm wearing all black. I'm basically going to co-direct.
Yeah.
Just going to stand over his shoulder the whole time and be like, move that camera a little bit.
Oh my God.
Get the fuck in the background. I'm like,
you know how quickly we'd be escorted off the premises.
I'm like, look, here, I'm going to be in the background, shoot my head, just get the square hair hanging out of my head. Be perfect.
Yeah. Dude, I got a little too comfortable last night at shoot. Yeah, I started giving directions.
You put on the fucking cap? That's what you have to.
I got a little fucking comfortable last night. I said a couple lines. I was feeling myself.
Hell yeah.
Started telling other people what to say.
Good. That's how
no,
you do
it. Was,
take it over.
Yeah, for sure. Power move. But no, I didn't know I was even going to be on.
Yeah, yeah.
Got there at 6 p.m.
Uh-huh.
Ended up being an all-night shoot.
Yeah.
So that was 6 to 6.
That's a long set life, dude.
I didn't realize acting was gay.
Yeah.
Acting sucks, dude.
Yeah.
That was 12 hours of fucking playing with my dick.
You're basically standing there like for 90% of the time doing nothing. That's what cracks me up. I've done like small acting stuff when people are like, dude, this is like, I've just been working a lot. It's like, this isn't work, dude.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's stressful if you're running the whole show, but if you're just some fucking noodle with four lines, you're just standing there jerking off.
You're just standing in the wings for literally for 12 hours.
You're playing pretend like a
Except
kid.
What sucks, well, it doesn't suck. It's fucking awesome.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Like, I mean, I was in every single scene
because
of the character I was playing.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was
That's
in,
cool.
in every single scene,
yeah,
which seems cool, until like, because that was the first time I was ever on set.
That was of your anything first set
real
life?
Of anything real. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
So like, you don't really realize how often, how they do every single take, so many fucking times.
Yeah.
And from every single angle, of every character.
Yeah.
Like crazy shit.
So I never sweat at memorizing lines because it's like you're gonna do the fucking scene a thousand times. It's like.
But well now.
Sick.
Yeah, dude. So now we gotta head down there.
Probably take the chopper. I don't know. Hopefully they have space to land a fucking helicopter down there, dude. Or just be blasting the cast out of the fucking chopper.
Or just an 03 Corolla.
Yeah.
Either one.
Yeah, either one.
But
definitely pulling that thing up.
Yeah, it's pretty sick. You and me have to head down to this pilot.
Yeah, it's whatever.
See if we. I mean, you know what? It's just it's whatever to us, dude.
Another notch on the belt, dude.
It's nothing new.
Exactly. Maybe we'll divert a sea of fucking eyes and ears towards it.
Probably.
We'll see.
I can tell you, Chad will be excited.
Chad Cobblaze, dude?
Chad's definitely all in, dude.
Hell yeah, dude.
Chad's a fucking man.
He's a fucking corporal lieutenant, dude.
So.
What?
We gotta hurry up and get something hot going.
I know.
It's funny that we're not good at talking about that pilot.
Yeah, well, it's hard.
Anytime we've ever brought that show up,
yeah.
It's always been like touch and go is what we can or cannot say.
Yeah, well, I just
so it's a little uncomfortable.
I just feel weird. You know what I mean? It's just like.
Yeah, we have nothing to do with it.
Plus, we never exactly.
We have nothing to do with it. We just know the guys.
And I didn't know if I was in it or not, so yeah, I was always like, you know.
No, I mean, we're probably still both going to get cut out
which
of it.
Which would be hilarious,
but,
dude.
But we just know guys doing something
I was
cool.
At work today thinking about you getting cut out of it, and I was just laughing, just sitting here, just like on the couch, like, this is fucking bullshit, dude.
Who, me? Yeah. No, I didn't say it was bullshit.
No, I know. I didn't know you didn't say it was bullshit. I was just laughing, thinking about you on the couch, like, man, fuck, this sucks. Then being like, oh, wait, we're back in.
Yeah,
oh, wait,
yeah,
we're
yeah.
out, dude.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, no, that's because this weekend, so I was supposed to have a three-day... Somehow there was some sort
you got
of mix up.
Crushed.
I got a 3-day contract with this TV show for Comedy Central, and I got a feature weekend at Helium opening for Ari Spears, which is a ton of money.
Yeah,
both those are a lot of money, and I needed it.
Yep.
And then the night before the show with Ari Spears, I got a call that was like, "All right, he's bringing his own guy. You're out." So I lost that job for the weekend.
Sucks.
And then I got a call from the guy who's making the TV show that was like. Yeah, we're going to probably change things around a little bit, so I'll be in touch, but disregard that contract.
Yeah.
Or not contract, that email.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was like, all right, cool, man. And I just hung up the phone like, oh, fuck. The wheels fell off. Like, it was supposed to be the best weekend of my life.
Yeah.
And then the wheels just
That's a hard flew lesson. Off. I learned that lesson before, dude, when I was a realtor. I remember I, like, set up a deal, and I was supposed to make $2,200, and I was just, like, instantly went to Brazil, spent, like, $3,000, came back, and was just like... All right, let's close the deal. And like we tried calling you. That fell through like 2 weeks ago. I was like, fuck.
You were in Brazil.
Fuck. I just ran up my credit cards. Like, I'm about to get paid.
Dude, when I left for Spain, I thought just it was so easy to make money.
Yeah.
Because like, I got out of college, made a ton of money,
uh-huh.
and then moved to Spain for a little bit.
You think I'll be back?
And I was like, I can just make, it's like I can quit this job. Who cares?
Yeah.
Every job you get, you're going to make like $70,000. Doesn't matter. So then I got over from Spain. I've been broke as fuck ever since. I literally don't think I've had more than $4,000 since Spain.
Damn, dude.
Total.
I thought I was going to be when I was in college, I switched from psychology to business and I started reading all those like Rich Dad Poor Dad books and like all this stuff and I remember I was like, "Oh, I'll just be a millionaire. This will be sweet." And I like was talking to my dad and I was like, "Dad, it's easy. You just have to buy assets." And he was like houses and businesses. And I'm like, "Yeah, dude." And he's like, do you know how much those things cost? And I was like, yeah, but you just get assets and then you become a millionaire. And he was like, all right. And I was like, you'll see. I'll be a millionaire by the time I'm 30. And then like eventually by like 20.
And here we are.
21. I remember at 21, I was trying to do all these different businesses and I just ran up all my credit cards. And like my mom got a letter saying I was maxed out. And I went home and I cried and ran away. Fuck you guys, it's so hard. I ran across the street and cried and came back. I'm like, can you guys help me with this?
Oh, God.
That was the start of my sick business career, dude.
Your business career.
Crying in front of my dad at fucking 22. And he's like, I don't know what happened. It all went away.
Oh, fuck.
I'm trying to be a realtor and a housing market collapse. It's so hard.
And then
I'm not a businessman, I'm an artist.
For me.
I like literally ran across the fucking, ran across the street and like sat there like, I was like, did I just fucking run away from home at 22? I was like, God, you're so fucking shitty. And I like went home like, what are you guys having for dinner? Because they're like, you got to fucking pay this shit. And I was like, I'm trying to, I can't pay it. I remember they like I begged them for this. There was just like, I don't know what it was. It was like it was my communion money or something. They put it away. It was like $2,500.
Yeah.
And I found the thing and I'm like, dude, this is my communion money. Give me it. Give me it. This is mine. This is mine. They're like, nah, you know, like I'm like, let me have it. Come on. And I fucking, they eventually are like, all right, dude, you can have this, but like, just don't be a fucking idiot with it. We're putting it away for you.
Yeah.
So I get this $2,500 and I tried like selling fucking Percocets with it and instantly got robbed. I instantly got robbed and lost all of it. So I had no money now. So I couldn't ask them for money and I had to just like eat fucking cheeseburgers and ice cream sandwiches for like, I was eating 25 cent Mighty Minis, dude. Some dude, I was like, yo, you got that? And he was like, yeah. And I was like, where is it? And he just pulled out a club. He's like, I'll bash your fucking head in. And I was like, fuck, you guys win. And I was like, all right. Back to the grindstone, dude. Back to the business grindstone. Dude,
I love your fucking business ventures. Your ventures are sick.
I remember I was like, I'll just sell Percocets, dude. And then fucking this guy instantly robbed me and took all my money.
You're just
like,
a terrible entrepreneur.
Yeah, I'm basically.
But you are fucking out there swinging.
Bubbling, dude. It's about to break.
Well, that's what happens.
Exactly.
I think this could be your venture that finally fucking explodes.
Dude, how sick would that be?
I think a lot of the shadheads are willing to, let's say, donate $1 a month.
Yeah. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Man, that would go a long way for us, boys.
That would
boys.
Change everything.
God damn, a single fucking peso, you'll keep me out of the streets.
$1 from each of you.
Keep me out of the Percocet trade, dude, please. Yeah. My friend tried to sell him Percocets.
I'm
going to
make
like,
a fucking Sarah McLachlan commercial with you in it.
Please, dude.
I'll just put you on this fucking air mattress shivering.
We should make
I
it.
I will remember.
That's Arms of the Angels. In the arms of
what
the
song
angels.
Did I think it was?
You were thinking, I will remember you.
Yeah, whatever the fuck
will
that is.
Will you remember me?
Isn't that the same, is it the same lady at least? Whatever, same fucking love. Thing.
That is, that's, yeah.
All right, good.
Sarah McLachlan.
Obviously, well, anyway, the
she's next, by the way.
The take of
look
you.
Look out, Sarah. You're next.
Why?
Those boys, dude.
What are you talking
we're
about?
Taking out all the divas, dude. Them boys are coming in hot,
who?
Dude. Is.
Oh, you're talking about ISIS?
Yeah,
gonna get
Sarah
McLachlan?
Watch out. You're next.
Don't joke about ISIS right now. You feel
and then
stupid?
We'd like the dogs. We'll take the dogs out.
The dogs. They are bad dogs. they have
goats
them in the cage.
Are much better. Those fucking assholes.
Yeah, they're butt
fuckers. Yo, fucking for $1 a month. Dude.
$1 a month, you can take us out of shambles.
Wow. 50 cents, I'd
think. Think about even if you're. Because there's definitely a bunch of these dickheads, zero chance they give us $1.
I don't know.
But
there's some generous
there's
boys.
There's some good boys out there that can, you know, donate what you want.
Two.
A little $5, $10 a month.
That'd be sick.
I'll tell you what, you give us $10 a month, we'll drive to your house and say hello. You can hang out with us.
That'd be sick.
You can just come live with us.
Let me tell you. Yeah, literally, you can move in.
You can come over, you can play a video game with me.
You'd
be sick.
Join me in the fucking streets, dude.
No, there's like a. There's a fucking thing. I forget what it's called. It's for podcasts.
Yeah.
That like for money a month, they get extra.
Yeah?
Well, anyway, it's time we start monetizing this sick ass podcast.
Yeah, dude.
These people are getting the sickest shit in the world for free right
now. Hell yeah. We hire fucking writers.
You can hire mad writers.
That'd be sick.
I don't think anybody would come up with
no
what you say. No one would come up with that.
You got to live it, dude.
Anyway. We're not asking for anything yet, but just prepare.
Prepare, dude.
We could be calling upon you guys shortly.
To open up the coffers, dude.
It is time.
Open up the fucking
We've
coffers.
We've been nothing but absolutely... Dude, do you realize how much, well, mostly you, have shared with these people?
Yeah.
You've given them your soul.
How much I've damaged any chance of me getting a real fucking like
no.
job in the
You're
future?
Fucked.
I can't. Well, I've also dude that on LinkedIn.
Yeah, you definitely...
I continuously write about being high on LinkedIn, and that,
well, that's
it's
hilarious.
Not helping, dude.
That's super funny.
Hell yeah.
But yeah, all the fucking knowledge we've given these listeners.
Yeah, dude. I mean, dude, for the fucking, just all that shit about Chipotle, that's worth $1.
Yeah.
Hello, right there.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, what'd you say? That? there's a way out of this.
Yeah, there is. Or fucking, you know, don't.
But yeah, there's no way, dude. There's no way you're ever going to have another normal job. Podcast,
no.
By the end of this, dude, you and me are going to be in a helicopter. Just flying wherever we want.
I'm going to crash a helicopter into the White House.
Oh man,
that is how I'm gonna go.
You think you're gonna
a motorcycle? I'm gonna as soon as I if I get like any sort of fucked up disease or like, dude, you got like 6 months to live. I'm gonna get a motorcycle, get a can of red paint and a can of white paint and blue paint, dude, and ride a motorcycle into the White House. Just try to hit it.
My,
I'll just be sick. It'd be a sick way to go. It's pure Americana.
You'd get shot in the yard.
I'd still probably. I just want to crash into the White House and it'd be fucking through blue paint. White plate and fucking my blood, dude.
I guarantee those
red,
gates,
white, and blue.
Those gates are tough to ride a motorcycle,
dude,
through.
You build a ramp.
Oh, you would build
you
a ramp.
Have you seen Olympus Has Fallen, dude? They got right through them.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they fucking.
They just ramped over them?
I don't know what
on
they
dirt
did.
Bikes?
I don't know what they did. I think they tunneled through.
All right, so that's how you're going to die?
Yeah.
You're going to suicide bomb the White House?
I'm not going to suicide bomb it. It's just me crashing into it. It's not going to cause any damage.
Yo, you're not trying to hurt anybody.
No, I'm just going to, as a patriot, dude, fucking paint it up.
Why don't you hit. Like the Washington Monument. That'll be a lot easier.
What's that? Which one's that?
That's like that tall obelisk. It's like just a straight fucking...
Oh, yeah. I thought this was... Oh, yeah. Lincoln's actual Statue of Lincoln. I might actually ride
you
a jet ski in the... What's the one? What's the pool?
Jefferson.
What's the pool they have?
That's the right by Lincoln.
I might just go in that thing. I might just go in that thing and just drown myself with a snorkel. Just fucking snorkel and cover the top, dude, and just go out. All right,
so either way, you're gonna kill yourself in Washington D.C. is what we're saying.
Yeah, basically.
There's not a lot of
options. Just pure 17s. I'm gonna go out just pure 1776, dude. Death to tyrants.
Why don't you get over to the Middle East and hit one of their fucking things?
That's not a bad idea either.
Give them a little what for?
I'll do a little ISIS what for.
If ISIS has their version of Ariana Grande. You need to get over there.
They definitely probably don't. It's probably a little fucking like hot 8-year-old boy.
Definitely,
dude.
A hot
like,
boy.
La, 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 la.
Oh,
Bakabazi, dude.
Oh man,
I'll go get their little fucking.
Go get one of those little boys, dude.
Harimiana Grande, dude, and fucking get
eye
them.
For an eye at this point. Hot 100%. Ass kid for hot ass kid. I meant Ariana Grande.
I know.
Of the victims.
Yeah, she's definitely the hottest.
Of.
Yeah, the whole thing, but you know.
That's not good.
Change the Facebook profile pics.
That's
dude.
Not good. Yeah,
not,
change
well,
profile
you know
pics.
What we're saying.
Fucking.
We're going to get ISIS, dude.
Change everything.
We're
going
to donate every dollar to fucking taking ISIS out.
Oh, yeah. Give us a dollar. We're going to stockpile ammunition and then one day
dude,
crash a helicopter
how
to the
funny,
White House.
How fucking funny. I think you've said something like this before, but switching the music. But how funny would it be just like in the morning when it's like, hey. Just the fucking the cast
to
get pirate on that and the cast
oh.
to come on and be like, oh the fucking all Akbar.
Oh my god. No, my goal is to that's how I'm gonna die.
What?
I'm gonna get over to I don't know, I'm trying to think of a lesser intense but still equally aggressive. You could do it in Saudi Arabia.
What?
Saudi Arabia is an American, you can go over there, but we'll get on one of those prayer towers.
Yeah.
When it's playing that music.
Oh my
set
god.
Set up a mic, go up there. Just try to do a set.
You guys are fucking gay,
just
dude.
Just try to
oh
do a set of
God.
Stand-up as long as you can until you get beheaded.
And just chomp a cyanide pill, dude, and fall off the thing. That's a good move.
Just 10 minutes and close with like, all right, fuck you guys, I'm out. Peace. Thank you guys. You guys are great. Cyanide.
They just hang you off an excavator, dude.
Oh, we got any relationships out here? Anybody? All right.
You guys smacking your wife, huh? All right, yeah.
You guys celebrating any birthdays? Anybody?
No, you don't know how old you are? All right. That's what happens when you live out in a fucking field. Oh, my God.
Celebrating any beheadings? You guys cut anyone up?
So how does one exactly clean a dirt floor, huh? Ha ha. Fucking yep. Shoot you. Get hit with a rocket launcher.
See lots of mud huts out here. All right. Well,
Oh, my God.
Yeah, that'd be
that'd
a killer
be
set.
That would be a killer. If you got on the loudspeaker, it's like, hey, it's like,
yeah.
Damn, dude, it smells like shit out here.
Oh, man, they'd have to climb up that tower like Assassin's Creed to get you. There'd be like 30 of those guys flying up that tower.
It'd be like, oh, you guys, they're all wearing like Old Spice fucking. It'd be like Old Spice, goat ass.
It's too racist.
No, it's not.
Dude, how many do you think you could fight off? If they didn't have weapons, those are little guys, dude.
If they didn't have weapons?
I'm a big bull up on that tower, dude. If they're
coming
there, one
like,
at
fucking,
a time,
you'd be up there
I could,
like King Kong.
I'd be like
just
Kong
fucking,
hanging
you'd
off.
Have like a woman in your hands like King Kong. Just fucking
with fucking drones circling me instead of those biplanes.
Well, plus, too, the footwear is not exactly conducive
footwear,
for, like,
dude,
climbing
up. Footwear,
dude,
I'm up there trained. I would Joe Rogan train for
100%.
Like a year.
Yeah.
I'd be fucking pure jiu-jitsu.
You would just, it would, you would get bored. You'd be standing up there, and you just, it would just be like the squeak of Birkenstocks sliding down this fucking pole. And like, oh, we'll get you. Oh, we will get you.
No, they would have to burn me out.
Did they smoke you out?
If there were seven dudes one at a time.
Yeah, they'd probably smoke you out.
I'd be able to do, there's so little, I'd be able to do like wrestling moves.
Really?
Yeah, dude.
That's
Middle
true.
Eastern men?
Yeah, that's true.
Well, they, just the average watch them, Middle Eastern man.
I think they'd probably just ram their Ferraris and knock
fucking
pole
down. They would start driving sick-ass Lambos and shit into the base of it.
They'd probably open the suicide doors and slice the pole over, dude, and send you down.
Yep.
Hell yeah, dude.
It's a hot cast.
It's fucking...
What are we at right now?
We're at 45.
That's enough for now.
All right, we're good.
Think that's good for the week, or do you want to take a break?
Eh, we'll find out. We'll close it. We'll do a little, let's just fucking pause it for now. We'll close it up. Man. Final words.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, we should probably give a, nobody lives in New York that's going to see us on Thursday.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's true.
Tomorrow we're in New Jersey, but I don't fucking know where.
Me either.
Thursday we're in Levity Live in West Nyack, New York.
Hell yeah, dude.
I'm trying to think of shows people can go to.
Didn't know that was a town.
June 2nd, Friday, June 2nd, come see me and Matt and Tommy Pope in Lancaster.
Hell yeah.
That'll be fun.
That'll Lancaster. Be really nice.
So
that's a lot
that.
Of fucking dong on one show,
that's,
dude.
That's strong dong.
Jesus Christ.
And then June 10th, this is a big one. This is a big one for me.
Yeah.
Harrisburg Midtown Art Center.
Yeah.
June 10th. Also, June 3rd.
Yeah.
Helium Comedy Club at midnight. That's me and Matt's baby.
Ooh, dude. Digital, our, if you haven't made a friend, digital graffiti yet.
Good friend Mecky Leeper helps us out.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Digital Graffiti.
Yeah.
It's fucking sick.
It's literally the best show.
It's the most lit show imaginable.
It's literally if the cast was a show.
Yeah, it is.
That's literally it.
So,
what else? Oh, dude, 22nd through the 24th, I'll be with Kurt Metzger at the Punchline.
Oh, yeah, nice.
That'll be sick.
And other than that, we're good.
Yeah.
What do you think, man? This was a sober cast.
It's a sober cast. This is a quick little fucking buzz drill. We've been giving a lot. We've been giving out. We've been giving a lot of content.
It's time to cut
dude.
These motherfuckers off.
Cut it down, dude.
Unless they're fucking dishing out loot.
A dollar, dude.
Just a dollar, dollar or on, 20.
Wow. Dude, yeah. If you want to get fucking
saucy. If you have money.
Yeah. Kick it out.
I don't. I got $11.
Kick it out.
I have $11.
Fucking.
I'm out here filming TV pilots.
Yeah, dude.
Well, I'm actually standing around the background of somebody else's, but, you know.
We got to shut that thing down, dude. Let's go down there and shut that down.
No, this is like, how do you feel about the sober?
I like it.
You like it?
Yeah.
This is like we've been fucking for a while, and then we.
This is lights on sober sex.
Only fucked when we're drunk, which is nice. That's nice.
Ah,
yeah. That's easy.
It's true.
You just slide in. You don't even care.
That's true.
You don't care what you said. Sober is difficult.
Yeah, I don't know. I have freaky sober sex, but...
No, I just mean that's the equivalent that I'm trying to...
Yeah, 100%. If you have only drunk sex and you're sober with the lights on, it's
sober
like,
lights on sex is...
That's what we're doing right now.
Like smiling at each other, you look away.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Well, that was me and Matt having sober, lights on, unprotected, raw, anal intercourse.
Of course.
And you got to listen to that.
And you liked it.
June 3rd, fucking Helium Comedy Club.
Digital Graffiti.
Midnight, Saturday night.
Come on out. And
go to that.
Chuck us a fucking dollar.
Yeah. I don't know how they're going to send us a dollar yet.
Well,
we'll
figure it out. Send us one. We'll give you an address. Send one single dollar cash in the mail.
Yeah.
We can't have the government up in our fucking shit, dude.
No fucking anthrax either, you fucking gay ISIS.
Yeah.
They're definitely listening.
Yeah, dude, they're beaming us out right now.
Yeah.
We must take the enemy.
We have a very bad the podcast.
Dude, if we got... Oh, never mind. All right, we're out of here. Later.
What?
If we got fucking attacked.
If you and me get attacked?
If someone attacks the studio, dude.
Ah, that makes sense. They'd try to stop
that'd
us.
That'd be hilarious.
Well, not for... I mean, they would hit a bunch of shatheads.
I'm talking about attack the studio.
Oh, if they hit the studio?
The part of the house.
I thought you meant like during one of our shows.
Dude, they would get fucking crushed.
The shatheads would rise up.
It's 3,000 fucking first responders, dude. It'd be 3,000 Flight 93.
It'd be 3,000 open carry.
100%.
We love fucking guns, dude.
Yeah.
We got to start getting more.
Send us fucking guns.
Yeah, send us guns and money.
$1 bills.
And $1 bills, yeah.
Don't ask any fucking questions.
Please, no more questions.
All right.
Good guess, dude.
Praise the Lord, I was born to travel. Feeling like Slash in front of the chapel. I'm lean back.
the less pull. Shit I smoke is like cholesterol. Spilled dressing on the vest at the festival, the best of all. Had a midget Puerto Rican at my beck and call. Best believe that there was neck involved. Fuck around and almost wrecked the sub. We took acid for 10 days straight up in the mountains. Yeah. Started running with the stallions. Playing frisbee in the West Indies. Did the tango with my kidneys eyes open. Now I know just what my kids need. Rockin' very loose pants. Yeah. Rockin' very loose pants. Yeah. Buried a million in the sand by the clock tower. Before I die, take a hot shower. Ride the Harley into the sunset. 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 By chance, I seen her in the lobby of the Ritz with a man, the one that swings the hockey stick.